use this saved preset right here for that montage. And man, I just love the balance between the warm and cool tones in this look. It's an artistic choice, of course, but I really like it. I'm gonna give this away today, but this is not a LUT, so you can't just download it and put it on a custom LUT. I'm gonna give the link in the description so that you can get it. It's a zip file where you can just double click to unzip it. And once you have it, go to Finder, Go, and go to Folder. You can also use a shortcut, Shift-Command-G. I also left this path in the description, so just copy and paste that here. And make sure to change this to your username. Why? Because it won't work, and we want it to work. It's pretty simple as that. It has to be the username where your Final Cut Pro is installed. This is the folder where you will paste the saved preset, and you should be able to access this in your effects presets once you paste it here. Again, this is an effect preset. That means you are actually going to get all the color adjustments that I applied to this footage, and then you can still adjust it to your preferences. I'm always going to advocate for more control. Not that I want you to be a control freak, of course, but the truth is the only way you're going to develop your skills and be able to express your own style or your own signature is if you have control over what you want to do or what you like to do. I actually pulled down the yellows in the highlights a little bit by going to the color wheels too in this preset. You can also play around with the mid-tones and monitor what it does to the clip. You can give it a warmer tone. Just make sure you keep watching your waveform so that you don't overdo anything. I also went to color curves too and made the highlights and the shadows a little softer and make it a little bit more filmic by creating a point here and here, and then pull this down, pull the highlights down and lift this up just a little bit. Again, don't overdo it because it's gonna look washed if you overdo it. The skin still looked too yellow for me, so I decided to use the hue saturation curves. I took the color picker on hue versus hue, clicked on her face, and lifted this point up just a little bit to take away the yellow. I chose the same point for hue versus sad and took some saturation off of the orange. And then of course I usually create this curve for the luma versus sad to preserve pure white and pure black in the brightest highlights and the darkest shadows. You see, you still have a lot of controls, but you don't have to start from scratch. Now, I started with a footage that was already pretty much balanced. So I'm gonna leave a video up here at the end about white balance. That might help you. You know what, let's put the preset on this one right here, this footage right here, because this footage was a log footage. It's in a completely different environment and a different skin tone. Not bad. It's a look. I would still dial back the yellow a little bit, especially on the skin, but of course, all of that depends on the project and or your preference. And that's it, guys. If you got any value from this one, subscribe and check out these other videos. You might like them. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.